When's the last time you saw SC have only 23 yards rushing at halftime? How about the time of possession for Cal? But the equalizer has been the two turnovers. Three fumbles in the first half for Cal, two recovered by the Trojans.
The other thing that was important about that first half, it wasn't just Aaron Rodgers' show at that point. In my mind, as someone who was covering USC, something really important in that game was the fact that Ryan Killeen had kicked that field goal and would go on to kick several more. Because if you go back to 2003 in that triple overtime game, which was had such a magnificent ending, Ryan Killeen missed a field goal attempt in the third overtime that opened the door for Cal to come down and Tyler Fredrickson to do his thing and set the stage for this 2004 game.
As we come out to start the second half of play, if you believe in history, USC plays better football in the second half, at least they have this season, and did much of last season. This is a different California football team they're facing today than they faced the last couple of years or the last 25 or 30 years. And USC's expecting that pooch kick again, but they don't get it. They get a line drive shot that goes into the end zone, and way back up here where everybody just left from, there's a penalty flag. So that'll come back probably. We'll just see what they do with it.
That's a critical mistake by Cal being offsides on the kickoff. They got what they wanted. They got Bush to shift to the short side of the field.
Cal will back up to the 30 and re-kick it, and we'll see where they position Bush. They had sucked him into coming over here to anticipating pooch kick again, as Dan said. But all of that went up in smoke with the infraction.
Pete Carroll knows that the Trojans crank it up pretty good in the second half. They've outscored their opponents 79-10 in the second half of their four games so far.
Well, they got Bush lined up down there with Reed, and they kick it. And they try to kick it away from him, but they can't. He drifts under it at the 9-yard line. Gets to the outside. Gets a crack. And he's brought down on an ankle tackle at about the 34-yard line by Mike McGrath. They come out with Lindale White as the deep back. And Bush is in the backfield as well, but he's up there in that slot. And Leinert comes out looking for it, throws short. Down into the middle, it goes to Chris McCoy, and McCoy will have a first down at the 47-yard line. Bush, the single back. He's got it. Running in traffic a goodly bit today. Picks up 3 yards on the carry. Ryan Riddle gets another tackle. He's having a big day. Webb in front of it. White gets it. There's the difference when you weigh 235 pounds. He runs into Lamiza and just bowled him over. Ball is on the California 43 for Leinert. He's back to throw. As time passes away, pass is completed to Steve Smith, and Smith is taken out of bounds at the 12-yard line.
Giordano is a safety number 20 here. Watch, he will run flat right here. There's the adjustment to the ball by Smith that carries it. Carries him and the ball away from the defensive back. Huge play for the Trojans.
How perfect the pass, huh?
Absolutely perfect.
White has it. Bouncing to the outside. Now goes back inside, realizing that pursuit had him covered. So just take what you can get. And what he can get is about a yard.
Well, he made a mistake when they first tried to bounce it to the outside. He's quick, and he's got good speed, but he does not have the quickness to do that against this Cal team. Where he is most effective is right in the middle, as we've seen already on this drive just a couple plays ago.
Leinert, air under it, into the end zone. Caught. Penalty flag down. They've signaled touchdown, but let's see about the penalty flag. Ineligible man downfield.
You know what it is, Keith, is he was lined up on the line of scrimmage. That made the tight end to his side of the field ineligible. He has to be off the line of scrimmage. This is a true
ineligible
freshman mistake.
Offense. Number 81. That's a 5-yard penalty. Number 81 was covered up by the wide
out. Well, Alex Holmes.
Yeah, Alex Holmes. He was okay. But as the flanker, Jarrett has to be off the line of scrimmage. Once he's on the line of scrimmage, that makes Holmes ineligible, and he can't go down the field. Good battle out here for this ball. Jarrett keeps his eyes on it. Again, a perfect pass, but it's coming back.
And he comes back to the 16-yard line. We're at second down and 15. And it's getting some heat, passes away, and that's thrown away. And Reggie Bush is visiting with the linesman, saying, hello. Did you see him holding me, sir?
Just saw the referee's family. There's holding on just about every play, almost every position.
Flag it anytime you want.
How big was that penalty? Just moments ago. We'll find out on this third down, won't we?
Yep. Bush is your single back. And it goes down the middle into the end zone. Dwayne Jarrett, touchdown.
So Dwayne Jarrett, this is his freshman season. He starts the opener at Virginia Tech. It's like this crazy atmosphere. USC is just hoping he can kind of step in and assert himself, because they've lost Mike Williams, who, you know, had attempted to jump to the pros and had to sit out the season. So they were really looking for Jarrett to step up and be that big receiver that could replace him.
Dwayne, it was a great athlete. He was had tremendous hand-eye coordination and an extraordinary catching range. And because we had built up that role with Mike Williams before, you know, we just fit Dwayne right into it, and he could do most of the things that Mike could do. So we just kind of didn't skip a beat when he started playing for us. And he was a come-through kid, made a lot of huge plays, and the guy we really counted on.
You get the feeling that Matt Leinart likes this young man, likes the way he can throw the ball high above the defender and be confident that Jarrett's going to make the catch. Perfect throw again for Matt Leinart. He is on fire.
Kick good. So bang, bang, out of the box to start the second half. The number one ranked team in the country goes to a 13-point lead, 23-10, over the California Golden Bears. Trojans will kick off now to the Bears, and they go to that tandem lineup. Now they're split apart. You've got Williams and Lynch back there for them. They trail by 13 points now. And Killeen hits it. They've not been able to get a return off him all day, and they still haven't. As California now needs to respond with this possession. J.J. Arrington is the single back. Aaron Rodgers obviously is the quarterback. And he gives the ball to Arrington, and he runs hard to the 25. That's a pickup of 5 yards for J.J. This by far the toughest opponent Cal has faced. Backfield empty. He throws complete to Arrington, and that's good for the first down out around the 32. So he's rolling up the numbers, but he's not rolling up the numbers on the scoreboard.
That ties a Cal school record.
Yeah, my stat guy, Mark Hoppe, turns to me and says, hey, he points to the sheet and says, you know, 10 for 10. Then he points again later. It's like 17 for 17. And so we know he's on, obviously. He's going to set some kind of record. And so you're just hoping it's all going to be short stuff. He's going to ding you down to the 10-yard line, and they'll tighten up there. And it turned out to be the case, but the guy was on fire. And nobody, you know, we knew who he was, and he was a good quarterback. Rodgers was fine, but he wasn't a world beater yet, and he didn't do the things yet that we'd come to expect in the NFL later. But boy, he was on fire that day.
This is Lynch, Marshawn Lynch, breaking loose. And picks up a first down up at the 44-yard line. He's got some quick in him, and he's got some size on him. Checks in at 200 pounds, 5'11", freshman, Oakland.
And what they say about this young man, the true freshman, is his balance. Watch as he takes off over the left side. Good jump to the outside there. Always with his shoulders square, and almost popped through for a big one. Good quick move to the outside, got him that big game.
Rodgers throws, well covered. Grootegood was all over the receiver, but Garrett Cross, the tight end, makes the catch and picks up 6 yards.
Another catch for Cross, another completion for Rodgers, who has not missed one yet. And the reason he's so accurate is watch as he carries the ball. This is what Jeff Tedford calls the top shelf. The ball stays above his shoulder.
Second down and 4. This is Lynch. One on one.
He kept dumping the ball to Marshawn Lynch, though. I know that. And Marshawn caught about 10 balls that day, it seemed. He wasn't throwing a lot of stuff down the field. He was completing a lot of passes, though, and did a great job with it.
Because I could line up out wide, and, you know, we could still have J.J. in the backfield, have a little fake to J.J., then throw me a little bubble pass. I think I caught about 8 or 9 of them in that game. The little bubble screen passes, you know, which we were killing them on.
Chase Lyman was involved in that play in that he had a block on a defender that gave Lynch a chance to do something after he had eluded that first man. This is Terrell Williams. That's a double pitch back there. Goes to Noah Smith. Smith got a block. Penalty flag thrown. Push in the back. Plays coming back.
Holding offense, number 65. That's a 10-yard penalty. Still first down.
Aaron Mertz with the penalty. Again, it's going to be from this side as Noah Smith takes over, and right here is going to be the penalty.
Yep, grabbed him and pulled him out of the way.
Yep.
Now, that new rule this year when they give the number and you knew who was going to do the most flinching when that rule was put in, the offensive lineman, they're being unfrocked here. But they prevent total mayhem by doing that. They don't have a choice. Sometimes you have to.
Now Cal is really hurting themselves this afternoon with penalties and turnovers.
On first down and 20. Down the middle. That's Lyman. Chase Lyman slanting. Comes up with a pretty good size play and pretty gimpy coming off the field after that.
Yeah, after that move, he tried to put on the defensive back. He may have sprained his ankle. And what a loss that will be for Cal. Been held in check pretty much. That was a big play on that first down and very long. The quick slant route. And it's just a needle. Perfect throw. Thread that needle by Aaron Rodgers.
Second down and 3. After that pass completion, they'll run it. They got a hold of Lynch. And they take him down for a yard loss. Marshawn Lynch trying to pop to the outside, but he was in too much traffic and there's too many tough guys in there.
So Aaron Rodgers now is set or tied a Pac-10 record for 17 completions consecutively in one game, held by Rick Neuheisel, UCLA against the University of Washington Huskies. They're checking Lyman's left knee. That's not a good sign.
Terrell Williams is set behind Rodgers. Aaron sets and throws quickly. Has his first down if the man doesn't give it away. He was past the marker when he caught the ball, but then he retreated trying to find some running room. Noah Smith and Aaron Wright took him down in a hurry. Crowd of 92,000, actually pretty quiet. The ball thrown down the middle, MacArthur. And it's first and goal, California at the Trojan 2. He caught the ball in front of Arbet.
Arbet bails out to the outside because he's got help inside from the safety. Safety late and shallow coming over after that great catch by Jeff MacArthur. He just had a feeling that he was going to have a big day this afternoon. Finally healthy from that pulled muscle in his side. And he's showing off right now.
They use formation to spread him out. Backfield is empty. Mandarino, the fullback, comes in to block now. Rodgers keeps it and going to lose a yard as he wanted to go off the right side. Well, they got Williams in there at tailback. He hasn't done much running today, and he still hasn't as Rodgers comes back and he's sacked back at the 8-yard line, and the man doing the sacking is Lawrence Jackson. And it's third and goal. Ball is back on the 8-yard line. McConan's the man in motion. Rodgers throws it into the end zone to McConan. Penalty flag. Matt Grudegood was covering Jonathan McConan, but there's a flag thrown.
Ball placed at the two, so this is where Cal was after the MacArthur catch a couple plays back.
So it's first and goal all over again from the two. They're on it right in the pipe, and it's a touchdown. Marshawn Lynch takes it in.
I want to say, you know, J.J. had just, you know, got us down there. Coach came and, you know, he said he needed a blow. And, you know, that's not like J.J. You know, so I was like, oh, you know, I guess I get a chance now. And, you know, the only thing Coach said to me going in there was, whatever you do, just hold on to the ball. I told him, I'm finna get this ball in there.
A little bit of a haze. We had some fog trouble the last week around here. Jerry Dan's Richard's house got stuck in it the other night trying to get down here. And it's a hard day.
It all turned out just
fine. Orange County and wound up in Ontario.
It felt like Ontario, Canada.
that hour of the morning.
I remember because I wasn't out there on the field, and there was a couple of us on the defense that, you know, we should be out there because we got to tackle this guy. And I think he bobbled the punt or something like that, and then he took off.
2 yards deep in the end zone, dropped by Bush, finally picked up by Bush, and coming up to the 10-15, out to the 20-25. Oh, here we go. There are no flags behind him.
You see this so often on a kickoff or a punt. The returner will drop the ball. The defense, the coverage team, starts to head right for the ball. They get out of their lanes. If you get out of your lanes against Reggie Bush, he is going to kill you. Here's the fumble. Now everybody in white is going where the ball is. Watch this power cut right there. That gets him into the open field, and now he's running. That four, sub 4.5 speed. Good job by Cal not giving up on the play. And Harrison Smith saves the touchdown. What a return of 84 yards for Reggie Bush.
Ball is squarely on the 16 stripe. And first down, Trojans. Lindale White right up the pipe. Rumbling, running downhill now.
You talk about responding to your opponent's touchdown. SC with a great return, and now, you know, it was lightning on the first play. Here's the thunder.
Lorenzo Alexander has come out of the ball game holding his left arm or hand, and he is a major figure in that California defensive front. Ball goes back to White into the stack. At the five. The ball is back on the 6 yard line. There was a loss of a yard on that play.
SC taking a lot of time to figure out what they want to run here on second down.
Leinert. Sacked. That's Meebain. He's a 290 pound sophomore out of Los Angeles.
They get a little bit of a jump on that offensive line as Meebain did that time to pick up the sack. But look out now. Five is back.
He's not lined up exactly behind the quarterback. He's blocking, as a matter of fact, into the end zone and intercepted. California's going to run it out. Harrison Smith would have been better off to have just taken it down. He'd have had it on the 20. Instead, they take him down at about the 12.
Well, Leinert got a little bit too much infatuated with the high, soft lob to the end zone.
You know, we had some special teams plays in that game that hurt us a little bit. And so, you know, after Reggie's return, to be able to get a turnover was big, obviously, because it was a game of back and forth of the ebbs and flows that typically go on when two very good football teams are playing against one another.
It was one of those bend but don't break plays. I mean, it was a great return by Reggie Bush. It was a tremendous effort by Harrison Smith, and then he gets that interception that really kept it, because if they would have got scored that, I think the lid might have popped off. But you know, we hung tough there.
I think what's interesting about that interception is the fact that it kind of was a snapshot of what was happening to USC throughout the game. Cal was outgaining them almost 2-1 in yardage, in first downs, and it wasn't like USC didn't have some opportunities, but when they had them, they weren't able to capitalize.
California 13-yard line, their side of the field, first down. Chase Lyman is back in at wideout. Give the ball to J.J. Arrington, hole on the left side. Carries it over the 20 to the 21. Picked up 8 yards. Aaron Rodgers, 19 for 19 and 187 yards and a touchdown in this ball game. Over his last two games, he has completed 22 straight passes. Well, they've managed to get it out to the 21, where it is second down and two. Rodgers gives it back to Arrington again. And he's close to his first down. Sean Cody brought him down, and here's Todd.
Well, Keith, new life in J.J. Arrington. Literally, he went into the locker room a few minutes ago jogging with a team doctor, reporting of severe cramping. He is back. Chase Lyman, hyperextended left knee, but he's got about enough tape to wrap up the 405. He's going to continue to go. Lorenzo Alexander for Cal, the lineman defensive tackle that went out, he has gone to the locker room with his arm in a sling, and they're saying right now it is a severe elbow injury. On the USC side, Steve Smith has also gone to the locker room with what being characterized as an ankle injury. Keith.
Chase Lyman just came off the field off that last play, and he was not letting his left foot touch the ground, so he's hurting right now. And the ball is flipped out here to this side to Mandarino, and Chris gets it up over the 30 to the 31, and he's going to pick up about 7 yards on that play. Second down and 3. Oh, it's quick. Pass is complete. Cross. And it's good for the first down, and a pretty good gain on it up to the near the 45-yard line. On the 45, first down. Running it. Oh, not this time, folks. Mike Patterson had the penetration, and Big Mike takes him down right on about the 41-yard line.
That's the first or second time we've talked about Patterson. Along with Sean Cody, the strength of this SC defense, and just about exactly where the Cal Bears are attacking them.
Twenty-four consecutive passes by T. Martin in a season is your NCAA record. They run it on second down, and Arrington couldn't find anything. Manuel Wright, the tackle.
We had a classic fullback middle linebacker confrontation on that play as Chris Mandarino went after Lofa Tatupu.
Well, it's third down and 14, and you got to tie him out as we come to the end of the third quarter. Here we go to the final quarter. California looking at third down and 14 at their own 41-yard line. Rodgers sacked.
Ball
fumble, and the Trojans have come out of there with it.
I think we were kind of known for, as a defense, as doing that. You know, we would go into the first half, have a game plan, and Pete Carroll did a great job of always adjusting. And we knew you couldn't win. That was one of his big things, was you couldn't win the game in the first half. And we always made great adjustments, I thought, in the second half, and did a good job of slowing teams down.
There really wasn't a disbelief. It was, okay, let's go get him. Let's stop him. Because that's the confidence that Cal was playing with in this game, that if there's some adversity, we can deal with it. We can overcome it. Whether it was the fumble by Rodgers, whether it was the missed field goals that Cal had to try to overcome, Cal just shook it off, didn't let it bother him, and tried to punch USC back. And that's that's been the philosophy, really, of Cal's program since Jeff Tedford has been there, is try to handle adversity and let's pick up and deal with it. And that's what the team did in this game.
Matt Leonard back, going for the bundle. Reggie Bush gets tangled up and falls down. There is no flag on the play. Second and 10, Leonard gives it to White. He's going that way. And he'll take it inside the 30 to about the 29. Tim Mixon, who's played some pretty good corner over there today, made that hit.
This is incredible that SC has had this type of field position starting on Cal's 45-yard line on average this afternoon.
But they lead 23-17, and there's Norm Chow, a familiar pose on many a Saturday afternoon in a lot of football stadiums. Bush is taken down well back of the line of scrimmage. So California right now is red hot.
Keith, you know, you got to give a lot of credit to Bob Gregory, too. We talk about Norm Chow's offense, but Cal's defense has been up to the test pretty much today. That was a huge play as he, on third down, called for the blitz play. That blitzes right into where that ball was headed. Talk about confidence in your offense. Fourth and 10. They converted, though, on fourth and 10 earlier today.
Down the middle, short of the first down. He's taken down at about the 28-yard line. Tim Mixon again making the tackle on Jason Mitchell. And they well short of their first down. So Cal takes over at their own 29.
Talk about confidence in your defense. Pete Carroll obviously has it, facing that fourth and 10, electing not to try to pin the Cal Bears deeper in their end of the field. They're coming up way short on the pass to Mitchell.
It's crunch time, and I just remember, and just, you know, I'm getting chills right now, just because of, you know, just how everybody was playing on the same page and same level. And I just remember we all knew what we had to do. And it was good that, you know, it was a great feeling that we did it, you know, and we got the ball back in Aaron's hands. And honestly, we thought we had it, you know. Okay, here's Aaron with the ball. Guy's super hot. You know, our offense is in a zone right now. Okay, we got this. This game is ours.
I wanted to see Malone or somebody kick a pooch punt. We've only seen one of those this season. And it's not as easily done as one might think. Rodgers still looking to set a record here this afternoon if he can complete a couple of more passes. J.J. Arrington carrying. That's from the 29 out to about the 34. So give J.J. 5 yards on the carry. Going into this series now, Rodgers has 21 consecutive completions. That's too short of the single game record of 23. And it is three short of 24 over two games. For a season mark that's held by T. Martin of Tennessee. Second down and 5 for California. The ball's thrown to Marshawn Lynch out here on one-on-one coverage, and he gets something out of it as he muscles his way past Scott Ware. We've got a 23-17 ball game with 12:28 to play in the Coliseum in Los Angeles. They scored coming right out of the box to start the second half, and California came right back, and then USC had it down, first down on the 16, and couldn't get it in the end zone. Came away with nothing. It was intercepted, and now California's trying to retain possession on third down and 2. And Marshawn Lynch gets the ball near the 40, and he will have a first down. Oh, look at this. He almost popped out of there. J.J. Arrington back in after a breather. And freshening up the legs, he pounds you. Run it. Got it. Mandarino. Mandarino is a 220-pounder, and he slid off between the right guard and the center and puts the ball on the Southern California side of the field. First down at the 49.
Yeah, not a lot of teams use a fullback as a ball carrier, but Tedford does. Mandarino doesn't get a lot of touches, but
it seems like on second and short, that's when they dial up the fullback, and he has delivered today. That's a couple of times now.
And Rodgers comes back this way. The pass is complete to Jeff MacArthur. He's got 26 consecutive completions. That goes over three from the previous game. So that is one NCAA record that he's put in his pocket now on this afternoon. A remarkable afternoon. He's got, what, 23 in a row.
Keith, I've never seen a quarterback do this at any level. Pop Warner, high school, college, NFL, nothing.
Without a doubt, that day I was in a zone. I think it just started pregame. I had that feeling that it was going to be a good day for me and our team. Felt very confident in the game plan going in and just got into a rhythm.
Cal had this quarterback that, you know, even then, you look back on it now and you say, yeah, that's Aaron Rodgers. But we didn't know it was Aaron Rodgers then. You know, Aaron Rodgers was a JC transfer from Butte College.
And he called Jeff Tedford down in Berkeley and said, Coach, I just watched the kid at quarterback for Butte. We better take a look at him. And you better come on up here because I need all the help get this guy. It's not going to be long till the world's going to be after him. They'll discover it.
I didn't know I had completed, hadn't had an incompletion until I heard the halftime stats as I was warming up for the second half. And they said 14 for 14. I said, whoa. Okay, that's a good start.
He was just in a rhythm, and it was one of those things. It's kind of like a pitcher throwing a no-hitter. You know, you don't want to talk about it. You just say, hey, our quarterback's hot right now. Let's just keep him out there, you know?
It kind of dawned on you in the middle of the third quarter is when, wait a second, Aaron hasn't missed a pass yet today. He's completed every single pass.
I had never seen a college player play any better in a big game than what Aaron Rodgers did. You know, and maybe... You know, I had never seen a quarterback throw the ball as well for one day as Aaron Rodgers did that day.
So I really had no idea that he was completing that many passes in a row or it was a record or anything like that. It was just kind of what we did and what he did.
Because he's a quarterback who's going to, you know, take what you give him. So, and he was definitely doing that. He knew that we were, you know, we weren't going to let anything go over the top. And so he was just, you know, picking us apart down low, kind of marching the ball down the field.
This dude can't miss. I mean, he was hitting receivers. I mean, and it wasn't like he was just going to one guy. He was hitting different receivers, running backs, tight ends. I mean, I had everybody involved.
Look, this is maybe the best defense in the country, and he's chewing them up. He's ripping them apart. This is USC in the Coliseum, number one against number seven, and it was remarkable.
I don't care what level you're at. If you do that in a game, that's pretty hard to do. And now you see what he's doing now.
We didn't know it then. What we were getting then was the glimpse of greatness and the foreshadowing of greatness of what Aaron Rodgers would become.
At one point, I was 29 for 31 with two throwaways. Heck of a day.
It's a chance right here to set a new NCAA record. He pulls it down and takes off, looking for the marker. Dimes got it. First down, California. And the ball is on the 38-yard line, USC side of the field. Southern California leading 23-17, 9:44 to play in the ball game. J.J. Arrington slashing to the 35. Second down and eight. Rodgers, pressure. Pass is thrown, incomplete. That breaks the string. So he ties T. Martin with 23 consecutive passes completed in a single game. 220 yards and a touchdown, and that time there was nobody to throw it to. He threw it in the cheap seats and broke the string. California has never defeated a number one ranked team.
Well, the odds are in their favor then.
Opportunity is at hand today. 8:53 to go. Rodgers pass down the middle. The man is wide open. That's Jonathan McConan. And McConan is inside the 25 and taken down. Give him almost the 20 on the play. Eric Wright, the tackle. Got away. Into the end zone. Throws it away. Lives to fight another D. Second down and 10. Oh, the ball was handed off, and it's a good thing. J.J. Arrington got something out of the play. Because I mean to tell you, there was heat coming. So it is third and four. K trying to come back inside, and nothing doing. Lofa Tatupu takes down Marshawn Lynch, and it's fourth down, and the loss is back to the 19. Tom Schneider's in for a 36-yard try he made from 39 earlier today. This is to pull within three, plenty of leg, and he missed it. Missed it right. Missed it by about a yard, right side of the upright.
It looked like that ball wanted to hook, but at the last moment, it straightened out, sailed wide right.
So we've got 6 minutes and 53 seconds to play in a good one. Southern California 23 and California 17. Number one against number seven. At the 20-yard line, this is USC's worst starting position of the day. This is Reggie Bush carrying over the right side. And Ryan Gutierrez made the tackle.
Time for our Pacific Life game summary. And how do you show a quarterback with a hot hand? Well, you show Aaron Rodgers as he deals the ball to all his receivers. Finds a fullback out of the backfield. Then he'll hook up with his tight end, Garrett Cross. And then this final one to Jeff MacArthur ties T. Martin's NCAA record of 23 in a row.
On second down. This is Lindale White going to the outside, and he's got some green grass to run on until Ryan Riddle. They need a conversion here. Otherwise, that yellow brick road might get something down the middle of it. Blitz and a sack. Wendell Hunter takes down Matt Leiner, and I mean he took him down. And the Trojans will punt.
Yeah, Hunter is going to be on a blitz, and he shoots the gap, and there's nobody in the SC backfield to pick him up. Watch him hit. Perfect timing. Nobody there, and Leinert lucky to hang on to this ball.
That is the fourth sack of Leinert by California. Mixon is back waiting for the punt from Tom Malone. Hadn't been much punting in this ball game. We've had one. A 62-yarder. He roots it out of there, and it's a beauty. Mixon dancing around, and the Trojans get him at the 35.
It's 23. It's not 24-17. It's 23-17. You're thinking, okay, well, this is it. Here's game. And that's a great thing when you're play-by-play broadcaster. You know, it's very rare you get that setting where you know that's the game, that those are going to be the plays, and so you can really sit up and take note. It's not like a bomb that beats you by accident, something like that. You knew this was it, and you're sitting up on the edge of your seat. I'm generally a sitter downer during games as a broadcaster, but I was standing up for those.
Here comes California. It is crunch time. 4:31 to play in the game. 4:31, 23-17, USC leading, the number one team in the country, leading by six. Aaron Rodgers runs away from the pressure. Gets one block upfield. That's enough to get him to the sidelines and protect him, but it's a big gain. It's all the way up to the 49-yard line. 14-yard pickup.
Rodgers showing wonderful mobility this entire game against a really agile and mobile defensive line of SC. Doesn't have anything, does not hesitate. Once he saw that opening, he took off, got it fortunate to get a block down the field. But unfortunately for Rodgers, Chase Lyman is not in the game. He's out with a bad knee. So his favorite receiver is not in there with him.
MacArthur and Toler are the wide people at the top of your picture. Ball is thrown to the side to Toler. And Toler is taken down almost immediately by Kevin Arbett.
Good reaction by Kevin Arbett. Two receivers on that side of the field.
Mike Patterson's had a big day. 10 tackles, 2 sacks, forced fumble, recovered a fumble. Rodgers passes away. Man is there. MacArthur makes the catch. And it's first down at the SC 37. Arbett the tackle.
Sixth catch of the day for MacArthur. Came into the game with just 7 on the season. that the Cal coach has told us he's healthy. And with Lyman out, he obviously becomes Rodgers' number one target.
Early on in the first half, they used Garrett Cross a lot, too. Haven't done it lately.
He's right here.
Might show up sooner or later here. This is Arrington running to the corner. Got by him. Keeps going and down right about the marker. And Scott Ware made a lick on him.
That was a heck of a collision there between J.J. Arrington and Scott Ware.
Scott from up in Santa Rosa. Had a whole long way from Berkeley. First down from the 30. Well, it's inside the 30 at the 27. J.J. Arrington with a carry. And J.J. has a yard, and that's all.
Now let's go back to that collision between Arrington and Ware on the previous play. Arrington is stumbling forward after breaking this tackle right there. And Ware sends him backwards. Arrington is the second player to rush for over 100 yards against SC in the last two seasons. Adam Chinobi Echimandu against SC for Cal last year was the first one.
Gained the yard, second down, nine. Terrell Williams on the field. Rodgers looking and throws. Jeff MacArthur makes the catch. Very difficult catch. He had to take it right off the defender's helmet, and he did. Justin Wyatt was there, but he couldn't stop him.
And this was his potential Joe Montana moment by taking his team in a hostile environment with a chance to win the football game. And he had him in position, first and goal at the nine. And what people tend to overlook or not remember about this is earlier in the game, he lost one of his favorite targets. Chase Lyman went down with a knee injury and was out for the rest of the season. And on this drive, Jeff MacArthur, his top receiver, was cramping up. And Jeff was doing everything he could to try to stay out on the field. So Aaron was relying on receivers. Jonathan McConan was a solid, capable guy, but he wasn't certainly a feature number one type receiver and a true freshman in Robert Jordan. But yet, behind this running game and moving the ball down the field with Arrington and Lynch and using these weapons that he had, and he took advantage of what was given to him, he put the team in position to win first and goal at the nine.
Hold your breath.
It's first and goal at the nine with about 1:47 left, and the place is going crazy. Anyone who'd been to the Coliseum for some of the great SC Notre Dame games, going back to 1974 when SC came back and beat Notre Dame, just how loud that stadium can be when it's at capacity. That's what it was like.
First and goal at the nine. California owns the ball. SC nine. Rodgers back. Passes away into the end zone. It is incomplete. It was intended for Noah Smith. Justin Wyatt defended.
The best offense in the country going against a team that has had some outstanding defenses. And I'll never forget, because, you know, they're going to either do it, it may take four plays to do it, but they're going to take their shots. And they're probably not going to try and run the ball the way that Aaron Rodgers had been throwing it. So on first down, he takes the snap, tries to hit Noah Smith in the end zone. Incomplete. And I remember looking at the USC defensive backs for their reaction. Guys like Justin Wyatt, and you know, you could almost see them exhale, like, ooh, dodged a bullet.
That was not a bad pass, but it wasn't as good as he's been doing all day. Thrown just a little bit too far to the inside for Smith to get his hands on it because of the tight coverage here. Justin Wyatt, 24th. The ball is thrown more to the outside, almost off the field of play. Smith White might have had a shot at it, but it was to the right hand. If it was to the left hand, it might have been a touchdown.
Well, Mike Patterson was breathing down his neck, too. He had to get rid of it. Second down and goal. Chance to win the ball game for California right here. Rodgers looking around and tackled behind the line of scrimmage by Manuel Wright.
Second down. USC gets some pressure on Rodgers. Manuel Wright, a defensive tackle, bursts through the line and sacks him for a 5-yard loss. And the noise after that sack, you know, was deafening. They were just going crazy in the Coliseum.
I think he wanted to shovel the ball right here. Watch his action there to Arrington. Arrington was covered. Heads up defensive play by the Trojans there. And how big does that missed field goal of Schneider just moments ago loom now?
California has taken a timeout. You've got a minute and 27 seconds to play in the football game. 6-point lead, Trojans.
Looking across the field at what USC is doing, and Carroll calls his players together. And the thing that I remember more about the play that came before it or the play that came after it was what Carroll was doing across the way. Because he didn't look like he was angry. He had his guys gathered around him and he was smiling. He was kind of like saying, you know, what I would later find out, you know, this is what you live for, to play in games like this, for this kind of a situation. You've done all the preparation. We know what we're supposed to do. You know, let's go out and do it. One of those kinds of speeches.
Yeah, well, I wanted, you know, I was hoping to help them feel a little bit calm in the midst of it all. It was as intense a situation as you can get in. You're right down to the end. The stadium was going crazy. You know, everything was on the line and all of that. And I wanted them to feel through me that we were fortunate to be in a situation. We got a couple plays left, and you know, it's going to happen. So let's do it. You know, and try to instill in them my belief that they were going to get it done.
Also opened up more football fields for them to work with this passing offense and the ability of Tedford to dial up the right type of play. Although you got to give Pete Carroll credit, because on that last play they knew the shovel pass was coming and they played it.
Pete Carroll is the defensive coordinator as well as head coach. Jeff Tedford runs the offensive show as the head coach of California.
Great coaching today by both of them.
Two plays. Terrell Williams and J.J. Arrington are both in the backfield. Now that's Williams, the tailback, going outside. Rodgers back. Pressure coming. Looking around. Shopping. Throws. End zone. No. Pass intended for Jeff MacArthur. Defended by Eric Wright. One more play.
Now when the pressure forces Rodgers out of the pocket, it really limits his choices down the field. Going for MacArthur.
And
I'm not sure Wright got a finger on that ball or not, but it certainly distracted MacArthur. The pressure right up the middle by Keith Rivers. Good throw by Rodgers.
Yeah, he had it on his hands then.
Certainly did.
He had him on. He hit him in the hands.
So you know they're going to throw, and you're just waiting to see what happens. I'm a fan too, so you're kind of watching and waiting to see what happens before you make the call almost.
And it is fourth down, and Aaron Rodgers has just spent California's final timeout.
And that's fine. That's absolutely fine.
I just think the sense of urgency and the calls that we made were more aggressive at the time, you know, and we were in a two-minute type of mode, so we were attacking more, you know, but it wasn't, you know, an adjustment to the game. It was just to the situation that we were dealt with.
We had a good momentum going there, but I wasn't going to let us get in a bad play. It was either that, you know, we didn't have a great play call, or maybe the play clock was winding down a little bit because, you know, we had some big plays. Sometimes after a big play, the tendency is to not get back to the huddle as quickly, so I didn't want to risk a 5-yard penalty if we still had timeouts.
An enormous moment for both these teams is at hand. Number one, defending, USC. Number seven, California, attacking. California has never ever beaten a number one ranked team. It is fourth down from the 14. Rodgers throws, end zone, no.
When we saw that ball sail through the back of the end zones, it was a huge blow to the gut. It's one of those things. Those are always the toughest ones. You know, when you should have, you felt like you should have won that day, but you didn't.
That was probably one of the most stressful, you know, 5 or 10 minutes that I can recall being in the Coliseum. And especially when they got down there at 4th and goal, you're thinking, God, Cal's definitely going to score. I mean, there's no way he's not going to punch this in.
We've just seen something that we've never seen before. For basically, you know, 3 hours is like watching somebody throw a perfect game. And then at the last minute, you're either going to close it or it's going to be an almost. And I think USC just, you know, raised the pressure a little too much. And, you know, he couldn't be perfect for the last minute of the game. It was almost flawless.
You know, just not being able to stop Aaron Rodgers, not allowing Aaron Rodgers to get 9 yards in 4 plays, I think has to rank with one of the, you know, the great accomplishments of that season for the Trojans.
It was frustrating. It's still something I think about. When you play at Cal, you kind of get to know some of the records and how long it's been since we've been to a Rose Bowl. And I think I wanted nothing more in my time there to be able to lead my team and give my fans an opportunity to play in the Rose Bowl. And knowing that game, at bare minimum, would have given us a chance to play in the Rose Bowl had we been able to take care of business like we did the rest of the season. That's probably one of the more frustrating things to have to live with.
Pete Carroll had the perfect defense called once again as the middle linebacker, Lofa Tatupu, got so deep on this play. Watch him right here. Watch how deep he gets. That prevents Rodgers from having a clear shot at his receiver. The receiver had beaten the corner, but because Tatupu was lined up where he was and he got as deep as he did, McConan does not get the touchdown. Plus, he had a slippage there.
You know, you could take some positives out of that game, and but with that football team right there, they expected to win every game. And I think maybe that nationally, I think maybe that opened some people's eyes on how good that football team was, what a quarterback Aaron Rodgers was. You know, I think that opened a lot of people's eyes because it was a huge focal point. It was a national game. And so I think with the audience seeing what the program was all about, yes, I think that that provided some confidence and probably provided some exposure for our program.
SC's players, again, just exhale with screams of joy. You know, the threat is over. They've held on. And it was a great win for them and kind of started them really, I think, on their roll towards what was going to be a national championship season.
Rodgers 29 out of 34 for 267 yards and a touchdown, setting an NCAA record for consecutive completions over 2 games at 26, and he tied P. Martin's NCAA record for consecutive completions in a game at 23. Mike Patterson, 10 tackles, 2 sacks, forced fumble, and a fumbled recovery. Our attendance was 90,008.
Special teams gaffes for SC. UCLA, rather, Cal, I guess. A fumbled snap on the punt, a dropped punt, poor kickoffs. Reggie Bush with a huge return and a missed field goal, or Cal might have upset USC.
Now here's Todd Harris.
Well, I'll tell you what, the buck stopped with you, and you dialed up the perfect defense.
I'm really excited about that they got it done today, because it took us a long day to get to this point. You know, they did a really nice job. They're a really fine football team. It's a great win for us. We're really excited about it because we did it here in front of our own fans, and it was a beautiful day of Trojan football.
Well, the number one team in the country should be challenging. You definitely were today. As you look forward to Arizona State, what do you change, or do you just relish this for a couple of days?
Oh, no, we're going to have some fun today. It's going to be a great day here in L.A. We'll get back to work tomorrow night, and then we'll be after it. We're going to have a lot of fun with this.
Congratulations.
All right, thank you, buddy.
Back to you, Keith.
Well, they get another test next week, a different kind of a test from Arizona State, because the Sun Devils are not easy, and they've got a week to rest, and they come in there with that Gatling gun at quarterback. Once again, our final score today, USC 23, California 17.
Honestly, I don't think there were games like that. We didn't approach games in that manner. You know, we didn't talk about one game bigger than the other. Those are things that we would do when we look back, you know, and reflect. But at the time, it wasn't a revenge game. It was a big deal for them because they had beaten us, and we went on to start winning a lot of games from that point on. We tried to take them all in stride, and I think that ability to be disciplined about that and focus in that manner was that which gave us the chance to be consistently on top for a long time.
That was Cal's shot. They win that game, they're probably in the Rose Bowl. and SC's not. And it kind of went downhill from there for Cal, at least for the next few years.
It was all over the place. It wasn't one area, and you can look at the special teams game, whether it was the muffed punt on a punt return, whether it was the missed field goals, whether it was the long kickoff return that they gave up to USC, whether it was the blocked punt or the struggle of one trying to get off from Cal. At least the special teams were consistent for Cal this day. It was unfortunate because it ruined a tremendous performance where Cal should have won the game. Cal dominated USC. And you don't hear this very often coming out of a football game with USC, but Cal dominated and out-physicaled USC at the line of scrimmage and manhandled the Trojans. And because of the special team shortcomings, Cal did not come out on the winning end.
You know, I was just happy getting the win. You know, that was a big win for us. It was a big game. That was national championship game on the line, basically.
I mean, it was an electric atmosphere, without a doubt. And, you know, so obviously going off that field, having an opportunity to win a big game like that in that arena, in that environment, was very disappointing.